morning, everyone, and a very blessed, happy All Saints Day. Our opening hymn, please, is hymn 362, verses 1, 2, and 4.
The first lesson is a reading from Revelation chapter chapter 7. After this, I, John, looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read from Psalm 34, responsorially by the full verse. "I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in the Lord. Let the humble hear and rejoice.
Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt his name together.
I sought the Lord and he answered me, and delivered me out of all my terror.
Look upon him and be radiant, and let not your faces be ashamed.
I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me, and saved me from all my troubles.
The angel of the Lord encompasses those who fear him, and he will deliver them.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who trust in him.
Fear the Lord, you that are his saints, for those who fear him lack nothing.
The young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
The Lord ransoms the life of his servants, and none will be punished who trust in him. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
The second reading is from 1 John chapter 3. "See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. All right, before the gospel is hymn 625, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Thank you.
Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Today is All Saints Day. It is the day when we celebrate the living and the dead being in communion with each other through our Lord Jesus Christ. We remember and name and pray for all his servants departed this life in his faith and fear. So, this morning I'll have just a little bit to say on three different subjects. Is there a ringing going on, or is it just me?
Yes.
First, today's gospel.
It might be your hand. I'm sorry.
Today's gospel.
No. It's feedback.
Which is Matthew's version of the Beatitudes. Second, some thoughts on saints. Who are saints? And finally, on death, for which I will borrow from some remarks I made here in January at the service for Dolly Beard. So, Beatitudes, saints, and death. The Beatitudes are Jesus' first teachings to his disciples. I can't do this anymore. I've got to go back. The Beatitudes are Jesus' first teachings to his disciples.
It is the sixth one.
The sixth one comes from the 24th Psalm. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Which brings us to the subject of saints. A saint is somebody of special holiness who has died. That's just my definition, somebody of special holiness who has died. So who decides? Who decides who is a saint? In the 10th century, Pope John the 15th decided. He decided who was going to be a saint. And their ranks have included, most especially, martyrs, but also kings and queens and missionaries and widows and theologians and nuns. And God bless them all, certainly. God bless every one of them. But maybe the list should be expanded. The list should be expanded to include all those souls who live their lives in service to the poor, in service to the sick, the disenfranchised. And the list might also be extended, we believe, to all those who live pure and simple lives of humility and charity and grace. Those people are saints. Here, with your indulgence, I would like to nominate someone to sainthood. My nomination is a young man named Jake. As some of you know, I have a younger brother, John, who just turned 72. He has been severely mentally retarded since birth. He has the same mental capacity and understanding and speech skills as a Labrador retriever. I know because I used to have a black lab. John lives in a state home in Faribault, Minnesota, where I visit him twice a year. He loves going to the A&W. He is the sweetest, gentlest soul I have ever known. Anyway, he and his fellow clients have round-the-clock care, for obvious reasons. And those caretakers are going to be first in line when we all line up to see if we're going to get into heaven. Those people are going to be first in line. Each client has what is called a one-on-one. That is one staff person who takes particular care of each individual. For several years, John's one-on-one was a young man named Jake. I liked Jake very much. John loved him, and he loved John. A year ago, Jake committed suicide. We will never know why. It was a surprise to everyone. I love the prayers that talk about great clouds of witnesses. Great clouds of witnesses, saints known and unknown. What Revelation this morning calls a great multitude that no one could count. Saints are everywhere. They're all around us. People who serve God in their own humble, gracious, and loving way. Special people who spread goodwill around just by the nature of who they are. So, of course, we remember today the apostles, St. John and Matthew. We remember the prophets and the martyrs. Of course we do. But there are a lot more saints than that. Finally, on death. My wife, Dee, and I were married in 2012. By that time, both our sets of parents had long since passed. They never met or even heard of each other. But if there is one thing that Dee and I know, it is this. Her parents and my parents are now enjoying each other and laughing together. They are best friends. We are as sure of that as we are of anything. There is a hereafter. Of course there is. Is there life after death? Yes. We don't know much about it, except that there's a lot of love going on. Fish don't know much about life on land. And we don't know much about the hereafter. But we know there is one. We say so all the time when we say we look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. As Christians, we believe in eternal life. John says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." This belief of ours in the hereafter is not allegorical or metaphorical or speculative or suggestive of something. It is explicit. It is the bedrock of our Christian faith. Nothing can separate us from the love of God, not even death. In the universe that God created, life and love and death and resurrection all run together in one continuous stream of mystery and fruition that we call eternity. In this eternal stream, no one is ever lost. We just take turns going to be in God. All the people who came before us left their mark on us. They are part of who we are. And we will be part of all those who come after us. God be praised. Love your neighbor. Amen. We will take a moment, please. Let's stand, please, and say together on page 326. We believe in one God, Maker of God and Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and unhappy, of one being with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated in the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the office. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the People can be found on page 328 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church and the world. Almighty and ever-living God, who in that holy word has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks to all men, receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, provoking thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Father Chris, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. We beseech thee also to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government and this in every land, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people, to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that rejoicing in thy holy creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. And we humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort from Succor County Court, Jose Alvarez, Rafael Barro, David O'Neill, Sharon Evans, Karen Evans. Are there any others? all those who in this transitory life are troubled, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And now on this All Saints Day, if you would please turn to page 489, we'll say a special All Saints prayer, second paragraph down. Page 489. O God, the King of Saints, we praise and magnify thy holy name for all our service who have finished the course of thy faithful theater. For the blessed preparing, for the holy recognized prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and for all other thy faithfulness served, known to us and unknown. And we beseech thee that, encouraged by their examples, aided by their prayers, and strengthened by their fellowship, we also may be partakers of the character of the saints and light, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We also pray on this special day for all saints, the first names of our departed loved ones, Bill, Mary, Edith, Tim, Ellen, Bob, Johnny, Martin, Hal, Paul, Edna, Chris, Theta Q, Nellie, Ray, Bernard, Betty, Nana Girl, Lessie, June, Michael, Matori, Martha, Beatrice, Frank, Frank Jr., Karen, Mary and Jack, Foxy, Willie, and Gertrude. We turn back to page 330 for the last paragraph. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Amen.
We also pray this week for our country. We pray that your will be done. And we pray most especially and devoutly and fervently that whatever happens, happens peacefully in thy sight, O Lord. Amen. Let us kneel, please, and say together at the top of page 331. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. Your remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of His great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with heart and repentance and true faith turn unto Him, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. bring it to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Peace, everybody.
Thank you.
Nice job. Thank you both.
You taught me well.
Well, now I just need to fix this thing. I want to say two things just briefly. One is, you know, we've been living through a couple of stresses, the virus and the national distress. And I think what some of us kind of hoped was that by now there would have been in remission, that there would be some lessening of those stresses. It could be, pray God not, but it could be that they're both just going to get worse, that we haven't seen the worst of it yet. It's going to get worse from here on both counts. My only message today is that if you're feeling either or both of those stresses, please don't do it alone. This church is your community. What is church? Somebody told me once, and I love it, what is church? Church is where when you go there and somebody says, how are you? They mean, how are you? It's not a pleasantry. They're curious to know, how are you? They want to know. I love that definition of church. This is your church. When any of us says to another one, how are you? They mean, how are you? And please know, I found this out on Wednesday. Please know that whatever you're feeling, the rest of us are feeling the same thing. And my only suggestion would be to get in touch with one of the rest of us. Get in touch with each other. Or come in on Wednesdays. Please do that. Or leave a message with the office and I will get in touch with you. Visit you. Whatever. But when people say we're all in this together, you know, we are all in this together. So please avail yourself of each other and of me and of this place on Wednesdays. The only thing I'd say is that we've just started very, very tentatively to think about Christmas. Lance and I have. So far, assuming we're not back in phase one or whatever, so far what we might do is have a Christmas Eve service. I will be here for that, and Nancy King will be at the organ. And a Christmas Day service, which Lance will have, and Joe will be at the organ. This church, I believe, downstairs, this congregation, has capacity for 130 people. That means we can have 32 and a half people here. We can have 32 and a half. We're going to have to figure out some way to manage that. 32 and a half people on Christmas Eve and 32 and a half people on Christmas morning. That's as far as we've got. Anybody else have an announcement or a birthday? Anybody? Our offertory hymn, I don't know. Oh, it's 691, please. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name evermore, praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to the Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And in institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue. Perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he prayed, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks to them, and gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of it. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commended us to thee. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy bread and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of this path. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy for our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our abounding duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, All honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God for the people of God.
Let's pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank you for that thou hast given us in these holy mysteries, that the spiritual food and the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and thus assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are ever privileged and ever perfect and perfect in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, who are also heirs to the wealth of thy everlasting. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you this day and forevermore.
Amen.
Our closing hymn is hymn 287, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Thanks be to God.